the most important conversation you ever have in your life is the one you have with yourself. You have to look in that mirror and know this. There's so much more in here, man. Because I can literally right now be a 300-pound guy spraying for cockroaches. Still to this day, if I did not look in that mirror and say, there has to be more to this.
Yo, VIP. Let's kick it. Collaborate and listen. Ice is back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly. Flow like a harpoon daily and nightly.
Will it ever stop?
Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights and I'll glow. To the extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle.
Dance.
Crush a speaker that booms. I'm killing your brain like a poisonous mushroom.
Deadly.
When I play a dope melody, anything less than the best is a felony. Love it or leave it. You better gain weight. You better hit bullseye. The kid don't play. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ revolves it.
Welcome back to my channel, everybody. Welcome to a new year as well, and this is my first video of 2023, which I hope is a huge year for me, my channel, and for all of you guys watching. Now, everybody likes to make new goals for the new year and make big goals, and it is good, you should, but a goal's really nothing without a plan. And I'm sure from the title I put that you clicked on this video because your goal, one of your goals at least, is to make extra money or to hit $50,000 in a year somehow doing something. Well, in today's video, I'm gonna show you exactly how to do that and how you can make $50,000 this year selling items on eBay. So if you wanna do some quick math here, to get to that $50,000 goal selling items on eBay, you would need to sell about 5.5 items a day if you're making an average of $25 profit per item to get to that $50,000 per year goal. That would be 5.5 items a day for $25 profit, 365 days a year. If you can do $15 profit items, you can do around 9 sales a day would get you to that $50,000 mark. So that's kind of a little quick math scenario on what you're gonna be looking for to get there. And we'll get into the big maths of that with sell-through rate and how to know how many items you need listed to hit that goal and all that fun stuff. But let's get right into the thrift stores because we need to find out what kind of stuff we can sell first. My packages are gonna ride shotgun with me today because I wanna shop before I go to the post office because I'm just too eager to get in there. I wanna find the good stuff before all you guys get in there.
It was very clearly a joke as it's almost noon by the time I'm leaving here. So I'm just lazy. I don't wanna go to the post office until after I shop. That's the real truth. It has nothing to do with you guys.
Oh, somebody's pulling up store number one. And the parking lot's rather empty, so we're happy about that.
Let's check for video games first. Usually like $5 here.
So this video today, guys, is more for you, less for me. Now, I wanted to look up a little bit of everything today and show you about sell-through rates. Now, this Wii Sports game, 2006, you look them up and there's 3,800 listed. We want to see how many selling. 6,800 selling, and for $4, looks like they're selling for 20 to 25. So this would be an excellent pickup. I did get a little bit of chicken feet here with these Nikes. I looked them up, they were decent, but they were a little overpriced, but best find, I think, for me, because I actually am probably gonna keep these for myself, even though I could get around 90 to 100 bucks, but they were a men's size 13 on cloud running shoes. They wanted 35 bucks. I paid 28 with my discount, so I'm all cool for that. I could list them for 100 or keep them myself. Another item that sells pretty well for me pre-owned are Crocs. These were only $2.79, plus I'll get 20% off, so just a little wipe down with a Clorox wipe or a wet wipe. $2 into about 15 to 20 plus shipping. I'll take that all day. I was in the clothing section. I found this Lululemon, which in Scottsdale can be a little risky, and yeah, $25. No thanks, but it's still good to see in the stores anyways. Now here's a couple items I passed on. This one for price, they wanted $17. So after discount, I paid $14. Now comps are all over the place. Sometimes I sell these for $35, $40, but sometimes like $20, $25. So for $14,
I didn't really think worth it. Now this Cardinals jersey, a little expensive, $18, and it's not a stitched jersey. The stitched ones sell way better. This probably would have been $30 and he's getting traded anyways. And this is where thrifting gets to be really fun. Now this was way in there. I had to dive deep for it. I saw it was an AirHawk Pro. So I was looking around for the price for it. I looked them up on eBay, and this is where sell-through rate really comes in handy. 23 listed and over almost 70 sold. They only wanted $8.50. Now, this guy was looking brand new, as you can tell when I'm looking at it. So I wanted to filter to the brand new comps. Remember, there's only 20 something of these whole things listed and 40 plus sold brand new, selling for like $60 to $100 brand new. So really excited for $8, and I'll get 20% off. So I'll pay around $6 for an item that'll sell incredibly fast for like $80 to $100. This is an item here where I could get it $3, I'd get 20% off, but it would sit for a little bit and I would only get between $5 and $10. So is that worth your time to list? I say no personally, but everybody's different. Pelote driving shoes. Now this was the dollar tag, which they just changed in my area, Arizona, to $2 on Thursday. So let me know if that happened to you too. But these guys had a 100% sell-through rate as well, as you could see, just as many listed as sold, and that's what you want for good, fast-selling items. These are some cool little nostalgia items. Now, I do know, I think I've heard that those Nerf footballs, like the really old ones, can sell good, but that was just a new one. And also this, for $3, this Pokemon box. I thought it was vintage, but then I looked and it said 2017. So definitely wasn't vintage, but still cool.
Guys, we're back
see.
In the car after stop number one. I thought it was a great stop. We ended up just picking up four items, three pairs of shoes, and that, what is this called? The AirHawk Pro. $38 for all four items. Now, all the items have a great sell-through rate. I was really surprised with those racing shoes. 150 listed, 150 sold. AirHawk, 30 or like 20, 30 listed and like 80 sold. We all know about OnClouds, how great those are. So four items so far for $38 that, I mean, just the AirHawk and just the OnCloud should be, I mean, OnCloud should be like $90 and the AirHawk thing should be like 60, just themselves. And we still got the other two items. So let's keep going. Let's hit another store. I'm gonna go to a consignment store where everything's a set price, hats $2, tops are like $5, $6, all that kind of stuff. So we'll head there real quick and then finish up with one more Goodwill today.
So I actually made a goal just to look at hats in this store because they're $2 and I wanted to throw some hats into this video. I did find this Ping straw hat, which the actual, like, I guess like cowboy type hats sell really well. I took a chance on the visor and it sold really fast for 22 plus shipping. So $2 into 22 all day. I snuck in the pants, even though I was only in the store for 5 minutes. I saw the Champion vintage logo poking out at me. These are the reverse weave and another one for $5. I sold really fast. I think it was actually $6, but I sold it for 27 plus shipping. So come on, I had to grab it when I saw it. So Champion reverse weave always does well. The pullovers, the pants, they sell really fast. I found a new Attag golf visor, and just for $2, I thought I'd pick it up. Johnny O is the brand. It's not the best golf brand as far as selling on eBay, but a brand new hat typically tends to sell over time.
And now a word from our sponsors.
Mother, what's up, Mom?
I don't know, for whatever reason, my beans and Frank keep sticking together. What? Who threw that? My YouTube friends.
Are you coughing? You're okay.
Welcome to 2023, guys. We're in a brand new year. You know, the inventions are getting out of hand. So I was actually hit up by this incredible company, Sepratech. Now, this is their new product that is selling like hotcakes. Now, especially me being an Arizona guy, out and active like you guys know I am, underwear that works is very important for me. Like, I really like comfortable underwear, and these are the reasons why. Now, this is a like athletic cotton stretch material that these are 90, I believe it's 96 cotton in 4 spandex, and they have so much stretch to wear. I like elastic waistbands, but I don't like it when it's super tight on my legs. And I have some pretty thick thighs, so wearing these and it not sticking on my thighs is really cool. But that's not even the best part of these underwear. Now, they are a 2-pouch underwear. What does that mean? If you guys can see right here,
we have a little hole for your Johnson all by himself. So, being in Arizona, let's try to keep it, I mean, I'm not really family friendly anyways, but let's try to keep it a little bit that way. Your Beans and Frank sticking together. No guy likes that. No one likes the feeling. No one likes constantly ripping them apart. That sounds like it hurts, but it doesn't hurt. It's just like an annoying thing to do. Now, these guys are designed separate tech, separate. They separate your Beans and Frank when you're out throughout the day so that they don't stick together. And it's actually a game changer. Now, not only that, they are a pouch underwear, which means what? Well, where your Johnson is sticking through, they have this little pouch that will hang over it that you can actually just lift up and have easy access when you're in the bathroom as well. So I think that is really tremendous. This brand was really nice enough. They were the first brand I actually worked with on my YouTube channel, and they had a brand new product that's doing really well, and they wanted to reach out again. So I'm more than happy to help them. Now, I have two links. You can go in the bottom of the description if you guys want to check them out. Now, this is our everyday 7-pack. Is what I got, and I think it's just about the perfect thing to get. You'll get just one of every color, same size, all that good stuff. And if you use my code RESELLS20, you will save 20% off your order. If you're an Amazon freak, you only have 2 weeks. My code will be live today, the 10th of January until the 25th. You only have 15 days to get in there with Amazon and save 20% off using my code. Otherwise, the other link is their actual website, which you will also save 20% off. And that will be a lifetime code. You guys can use that whenever you want. So go ahead and shop Separtech, get you some underwear, and let's get right back into the video.
All right, guys, after the consignment store, not bad. So I got two pairs of hats, $2 a piece. I think one of them we can make 25, the other one we can make 15. And those Champion Reverse Weave Vintage sweatpants sell great. They're kind of like a jogger style, so $35 for those. So let's go ahead. We are right outside our last Goodwill of the day. Last stop of the day. So far pretty good. So let's finish up here.
Okay, so right when I walked in the back electronics section, it was a madhouse because they're bringing out some stuff, but I, like the savage I am, snagged the two only good looking items that would probably be anything out of the cameras that came up. Now, I've heard some great things about just camera lenses, which is that item on the left, or cameras like vintage ones, and you can just tell by the case, the quality. This is a pretty nice camera. Now, it is a Nikon Japan style like camera. Now, they wanted $30, so I was a little scared because I didn't know how to test them. I would pay $24 after discount. The sell-through rate was decent. It wasn't 100%, but comps were a little bit all over the place, but between anywhere from like $30 to $40 for like untested, all the way up to like $100, $120. Now, paying $24 and not being exactly sure about how it works, I did actually end up passing on it because the sell-through rate, you know, it was okay. It was there. It was about what I wanted, you know, over 50, 60, 70% sell-through rate. But, you know, for spending $24, I wanted to spend that money a little bit more wisely for this video. So I ended up sadly just passing on this item. So I did look up the lens that came with it. Now, they wanted $14 for this lens, which some lenses could be worth $100, $200 just themselves. So I'm like, okay, let's look up this lens then. So I went ahead and typed in exactly what it was saying with the dimensions and all that. When I looked it up though, there were like 140 listed. And when you filter to sold on 140 listed items, and you only see, what is this, 14 sold, that's just not going to be a fast selling item. So I did put them both back, but I did find this RC monster truck, $4, 60 listed, brand new. And how many sold was 60 listed? We got 59 sold. So boom, 100% sell through rate. So that means it should sell fast, right? It did. $25 free shipping for a $4 kids toy. I'm cool with that. And this is an item that I've sold a bunch in my past, a FootJoy Athletic Fit Polo. Cool designs like this sell, should be $30, $40.
So I'm home now, and we did pretty good, I think. You know, I tried to give you guys tons of examples of picking up kind of everything so you guys can see. Shoes can sell, clothes can sell, electronics can sell, toys can sell, video games can sell, all that kind of stuff. But although we did pretty well and found a little bit of everything to sell, how about our very beginners who have nothing on their store yet? I thought of another idea, which is something that you definitely need to do because you never know.
and I found one. So looking through your house, you never know what kind of stuff you have laying around, what it could be worth, and all that fun stuff. So you always will be surprised. Now I found these Good Feet Super Athletic Cushion Arch Supports. 2-3 years ago I got these, never opened them, never used them. I looked them up on eBay and check this out. They have like 7 or 8 listed and over 20 sold. 2 of them brand new are selling for like 50, 60 bucks. So this guy should be about a $30 profit item that was for free because I just had it laying around my house, which brings us to 10 items picked up today. So now let's get into the actual numbers and exactly how you're gonna make $50,000 this year. All right, everybody. So for today's goal of the video, I really wanted to make simple math and really break it down to you how honestly simple making $50,000 for your eBay business or just extra doing eBay can actually be for you. I didn't want to do that just saying sell X amount of stuff on eBay without giving you examples of like what kind of stuff can you sell. So that's why we went shopping first. We went shopping first so we can show you that it can be done. There are items out there in Goodwills and these are the kind of items that you can look for and sell. And also we wanted to stress sell-through rate and looking up those items in Goodwills and making sure they will sell and they will be actually a good addition to your business. Also, importantly enough, adding in kind of examples of things that you might think would be good. And yeah, it looks like one sold or they listed pretty high, but it actually might not help you reach your goal because you might just be spending money on it and it sits for, and those items sitting for a while is gonna hurt your sell-through rate and basically mean you're spending more money to make the same amount of money goal. When you basically, to make that $50,000, you realistically wanna spend as little as possible. Like, yeah, you can spend $100,000 to make 50, but is that really, you know, realistic for most of us? So let's go ahead and break these numbers down. All right, so if you remember earlier in the video, I laid down those two paths with quick math on ways that I think are great because you can grow way beyond this if you wish. Now, $25 profit items or $15 profit items are the two paths. Now the $25 profit item path, you only need to sell 5.5 items per day, which would mean 165 sales a month, 1,980 sales a year. With that $25 average profit price at that 5.5 sales a day, that would make you $137.50 profit per day. Now times 365 days in a year, $50,187.50 per year. Now, if we want to do $15 profit items, which easier to find, you can do 9 sales a day, which would mean you need to sell 270 items a month, 3,240 items per year. Now those 9 sales at an average of $15 per day would give you $135 profit every day. Now times 365 days in the year, you would be left with $49,275 over the course of the year. So now we know with the $25 model or $15 model, we need to sell either 165 items per month with $25 or 270 items per month with $15 profit. So now, how are we gonna make sure to hit those goals every month? Okay, so perfect for us. I need to sell either 165 items a month and make $25 on average on them. Maybe I can make 40 on some, 15 on others, average 25. Or I can sell 270 items a month and make $15 profit. So some items I might only make $5 to $10. Some items I might make that $25. But in total, $15 is your average profit. So those are my two ways to get there. So how, first off, Forrest, how am I gonna know that I can sell that many items each month? How can I sell that many items per month and make sure it's consistent every month? Well, that's gonna be your 90-day total and your sell-through rate. Like I've preached from day one, sell-through rate is so important. It will tell you all you need to know about everything with your business. As we've talked about in the past and in today's video, when you're looking up an item in a store that you wanna potentially add to your business, you're thinking, I might be able to pick this up and make some profit on it. What you do is you look up that item, but looking up the item isn't what's gonna give you that information. What they're listed for is not gonna give you that information. Not even really what they're selling for. Sure, what they're selling for is a good gauge of what you could get for the item, but it's not really gonna tell you the demand of the item or if it's gonna sell fast when you get it. And honestly, if it's even gonna sell altogether at all. So when we are looking up those items, you need to see how many are listed. And then when you filter to sold, you need to see how many are selling. Then you can start gauging the prices to see if it's worth it. So realistically, when you're shopping, I like to say a minimum, like I shoot for fast selling items to try to spend as little to make that $50,000. I would look for items with a minimum 65% sell through rate. So what does that mean? Say you look up an item and there are 100 of them listed. To keep the numbers nice and easy, say you look up like a certain brand of a baseball glove or something pre-owned, and there are 100 listed. When you filter to sold, you need to see at least 65 of those selling. What does that really mean with 65 selling out of 100 sold? Well, eBay, just like your 90-day total, that information they're telling you is within a 90-day time frame. So, meaning if there are 100 listed, 65 sold within 90 days, that means if you list it, you would have a 65% chance of selling that item, if priced correctly, within 90 days. So, most likely, I really like shooting for items with a 100% sell-through rate, which kind of guarantees me that product will move in 3 months. So now how does this exactly come into play with your 90-day total and how many items you need to be able to make sure you're gonna sell that much each month to hit that $50,000 goal? Basically, okay, so I know I need to sell either 165 with this model, 270 with this model every single month. So how many items do I need to have listed to ensure that that's gonna happen and I'm gonna make at least minimum that much profit each month? This is what you're gonna do. You're gonna treat your 90-day total just like one item you're looking up on eBay. Kind of weird, right? So you're gonna see how many are listed in your store versus how many have sold within those last 3 months. Now let's take my example here. I can't remember if it was like, I have like 860 or something like that listed, 590 sold. So 590 items selling within 3 months means when divided by three, I'm selling close to 200 a month with this example. So I'm over that 165 for $25 per item profit. So what you would do here, say you're over that goal of 165 sold, but say you're not making that 50,000, what can you do there? You can then either A, work on your price, work on your average sale price, your average profit price, learning more about more items that could sell for better. Or you can go the other way and just start scaling your business more and start picking up more items for 10 that only sell for 20, just to get those $5 profits thrown in there and bump you from 197 sales per month to that 270 to get to that goal. Or if you can really focus more on better quality items, better priced items, better profit margins, all that good stuff, you might be a little more picky in stores, so you would have a little bit less items, so that 197 would turn into about 165. But when you're making $25 profit, you're actually making more money per item. My examples, you guys saw me today, we picked up 9 items plus one for free at the house. For a total, what'd we spend? $64 today, that was it. So an average of $7.10 per item. Now, everything's listed on eBay for well over $350 plus shipping. So an average of about $39 plus shipping per item, which after cost and fees would put me around $28 to $29 average profit on those items. So 10 of them, I would need to sell about 5 a day. So I would be good for about 2 days worth of inventory. Now, I did not do too much shopping today. I only went to 3 stores. I was very quick because I just tried to get basically like one of everything, or at least show you one of everything of kind of items you can see that could sell. But let's be real, guys. I mean, look right here. Look how many thrift stores can be in your area. This is just Goodwills. I have like 30 of them within a half hour. You have thrift stores, you have consignment stores, you have Savers, you have so many places you can go. Salvation Army. All of that. I hope you guys were able to gain some value today to kind of see how you can use eBay's tools to help you kind of figure out exactly what you need to do to hit your financial goals. Now, 15, 25, those are really basic base model, little models for you, basically, in a way to do. So you can, if you're selling, you know, average prices for more than 25 bucks profit, you're killing it. You don't even need to sell 165 items a month to get that $50,000 profit. But that also shows you how far you really can go with eBay. Now, what if you can get to 10 items sold a day for $30 profit?
you know, just little things like that. Hopefully plant those seeds in your guys' head, get you guys motivated, get you guys out there. I hope you did enjoy today's video. If you did, please go ahead and smash a thumbs up. If you're new here, this is your first time and you enjoyed it, thanks for sticking around this long. Go ahead and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out. You know, I'm gonna be firing in 2023. This is a big year for me in YouTube, you know, thanks to you guys. I'm definitely gonna hit 1,000 this year. We might hit 2,000 this year. We might hit 5,000 this year. I guess we'll find out. I will see you guys at the next one. Peace.
What's the lowest amount of money a guy should spend on a wedding ring for you?
Oh, it should be like for sure 30, 40K.